So YOLOv10 is in, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to run inference using YOLOv10. Okay, so I've prepared a Google Colab notebook for you guys, so you just have to follow all the instructions and then you will get it done. This is very simple because I've summarized this notebook. Everyone at all can just follow these steps in this video and also do the same. The first thing is to connect your runtime to GPU provided by Google Colab. So you click on runtime, and then all you have to do here is to click on change runtime type and make sure you selected the T4 GPU. This is free, it's provided by Google Colab, and this will accelerate our model speed. So right after saving that, you can see it's connecting to that particular GPU, and we got a success check mark right here that is being connected. The next step is to clone the YOLOv10 repository, okay? So this is the particular GitHub repository for YOLOv10. You can also check it up and start it, okay? So what I'll do here is to click on this to install all the dependencies from that particular repository. In other words, to clone that repository. All right, so right after cloning this repository, we also install supervision, which I don't think I'll be using it, but anyways, let's install it. All right, then we'll move on to downloading the model weight. So actually YOLOv10 comes with a lot of weight. So you can see we have about 6 weights here, and we are going to download all. You can use any of these weights you want, but I think I'll be using the first one. So I'll just run this cell, and this will go ahead and download all the weights and store them in a folder called -p. Okay, you can modify this name so that I store it in the folder of your choice. So right here, if I check here, you can see all these weights will be downloaded here, and we can go ahead and use them. Okay, so if you have downloaded the model weight, the next thing is to bring in your video file or your picture you want to run inference on. So I'll just drag this picture right here and I'll drop it here, and it will load. Just click OK and this picture will load. So you can see the picture right here, and I can just copy the path and then I'll use it in the code to run inference and see how the model performs on this particular picture. So there are two ways you can use the CLI to run inference, and in this case you just have to give the path to your model. So !YOLO, the task here we want to perform is to detect, the mode is to predict, and we are giving a confidence 25. You can increase it, but I think this is a rule of thumb. We are specifying save equals true because we want it to save in the working directory. Okay, so the model here, this is a tricky part. You have to go and choose any model you want to use. So over here you can see we have a lot of models, so if you want to use this one, just click here and copy the path and replace it right here. So you just have to put the model here and you will go ahead and use it. Then source here has to do with the image or video file you want to use. So in my case, I want to use this image I've brought into Google Colab, and the name is right here. So I also copy that path and have to replace it right here. Okay, so this is the image I want to use, and from here I can run this code. Okay, so this is running, it's utilizing the GPU, making it very fast. So at the end of the day, you can see this is saved in a folder called runs, detect, and predict. Okay, so when I come back here, I open runs, this folder is created automatically. I can open detect, and in predict, I have to see my result. So right here is my result, and I can go ahead and load and visualize it in my code. When you double click on it, so it's going to pop up and you can see it at the other side. Or you can even download it and visualize it on your machine. Anyways, it will work. So for me, I want to just visualize it here. So from IPython, I'm importing image, and right here I can just specify the path to that particular file. So I'll paste it here, and I'm specifying the height to be 600. You can change it. Let me even make it 500 so that it becomes a little bit shorter. And I can run this code, and you can see right here YOLOv10 in action. Guys, so it's detecting this image with confidence of 90%. So I think it's great, and the zero here means it's a person, so that's the first index. So you can see how great this model is working, detecting person. I think the thing to look out for in YOLOv10 is that it's faster, a little bit faster than YOLOv9, and also it has reduced parameters, and that is what contributes to it being very fast. Okay, the other method to use is to use the Python SDK. So you can see over here we are importing it from Autoralities. So the same thing, we import YOLOv10 from Autoralities, and here you just give the path to the model you want to use. And I've showed you that we've downloaded many models right here, so you can use any of them. In my case, I'm using the first one. All right. So you put the model here, and also over here you show the image. Okay, so the image you want to visualize, you have to show it here, and you can run this. Okay, so that's it. It's been run, and if you want this one to be saved, you can also specify save is equal to true here. But in this case, I want to show you guys how you can get the bounding box information and also get the confidence information, so that you can even use OPCV to draw the bounding box yourself or go get those coordinates yourself. So right after that, you can run this cell result at the first index.boxes.xyxy, and you can see this will give you the bounding box, and it has also specified that we are using CUDA, which is the GPU. In case you want to get the confidence, it's the same thing, result at index0.boxes.conf, which stands for confidence. It has detected this image with 96% confidence. Also, if you want to get a class, the particular class this image belongs to, you can just run this, and this is class 0, which is equivalent to person if you are familiar with the COCO dataset. Okay, so 0 stands for person, and so on. All right, so now after getting these tabs, you can also go ahead. This is some boilerplate code thing. You can go ahead and use this to show this image using OPCV. So import OPCV, and from Autoralities we are importing YOLOv10. And also, you know, cv2.imshow doesn't work in Google Colab, so they have an alternative from Google Colab.patches, import cv2_imshow. So this is what we use to show the image. And over here, we are doing the same thing, loading the model, specifying the path to the image you want to use, and we are passing the image into the model. And over here, we can get the bounding box by doing .boxes.xyxy. So normally this returns to you a PyTorch tensor, but OPCV works with NumPy array, so I just need to convert this to array. That's why I brought it back to the CPU and to .NumPy, because NumPy works with CPU and not GPU. So we do .CPU, and this will bring everything down to CPU, and then it can convert to NumPy array. Right from that, I'm extracting the coordinate x, y, width, and height, and this is equal to our bounding box. And over here, those values will be float point values. OPCV works with integers. Okay, so there's cv2.rectangle function use integers, so I have to cast this back to individual integers. And over here, what I'm doing is to show it. So I'm showing the image, and I'm drawing the rectangle on them, and also I'm choosing the color right here. So this is red, and I'm giving the thickness of the line to be 8. Okay, you can increase it. And finally, I'm using the cv2.imshow image, and I can go ahead and run this to see the result. All right, guys, so here we go. You can see how well this has worked out. It has been able to detect myself in the image very well. I think the localization is also very good here, and everything is cool. So this is how simple you can run inference using YOLOv10. The same process applies to video files. So in case you are using video file, you just have to replace the file path with what video file, and it will save the video file here. Just has to take some time to run on video files. Okay, so it's the same way. Once you have done it for image, you do follow the same step for video file, and that's pretty much it. So guys, this is how you can run inference using YOLOv10. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Give me a like, and also subscribe so that I don't miss any of the future tutorial.